Hello, thank you for joining me. I'm standing on a bridge above the M25 between Heathrow Airport and Chertsey. You may be able to see that bridge just there. That suspension bridge carries the railway line from Virginia Water down towards Weybridge over the M25. Now, people who are interested in railways do tend to notice it because it's unusual. It's a suspension bridge. But what they may also notice, they continue along the M25 anti-clockwise. Just down here, there's a little hill. And if you look at that hill closely, you'll see there's a miniature railway around the bottom of it. That hill is Cockcrow Hill, and that is the home of the great Cockcrow Railway. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to jump in my Lada, which is parked here. I'm going to go for a little drive round the corner to visit the great Cockcrow Railway. So the great Cockcrow Railway started life in 1946. It was set up by a man called John Samuel. But it wasn't at his present site, it was at his home called Greywood over in Walton-on-Thames. He had quite an extensive railway known as the Greywood Central Railway, built to 7.25-inch gauge. But then what happened? When he passed away in 1962, Ian Allan, the famous publisher of the ABCs, the Trainspotters book, he came to the rescue and he purchased the railway and moved it to this site we're going to today. It was a former piggery over near Chertsey, near a little village called Lines. It's about a mile away from Chertsey, so we're just going to continue along here till we come to the railway. So in the mid-1960s, they began rebuilding the railway, starting from Harkwick Central, and it's gradually extended and got longer over the years to the point that you've got what we will have today, quite an extensive railway. Here we are, you can just see the tourist sign. It says open and steam trains today, which is what we like to see. So we're just pulling in now. You can just see ahead of us the new station building at Hardwick Central, which they've had built. And there's a few people there waiting to get on the train. So I'm gonna go and park the car and we're gonna go and ride the two routes. There's two routes here. There's the green route and the red route. So if you want to do all the track here, you effectively need to do both routes. So that's what we're going to do here today. So I've arrived here at the Great Cockcrow Railway in my Lada. There's the station building, which is quite new. Certainly when I last visited here, I think it was about 2008 I last visited. It's another classic car in the car park. Wasn't here. So what we're going to do, we'll go and buy our tickets. There's, as I said, there's two trips, the green route and the red route. We're going to do both. This is the new station building. With a platform here, has the feeling of being at a disused railway, but it's not a disused railway. And there's a tea room in there, so you can, so afterwards I'll probably sit and have tea and cake and watch trains go by, which is always a very nice thing to do anywhere like this. So we're going to walk up here, it's even complete with signal. So let's go and see what we can see. So yeah, tea room's in there, I think there's toilets and everything, and the ticket office is here. So this is not a disused station, this is a new miniature railway station, but the station isn't miniature, just a railway. So there's the signal box. A signal rather, and there's a mile post. Now we're coming to here to the ticket office. There's actually a loco, WD loco, called Longmore on display here. So I'll buy my ticket there in a second. Oh, there's some various books to buy. Oh, this is interesting, isn't it? Talk about Ian Allan. This is an ABC, so this is the books that Ian Allan produced, and I suppose it was money for making his books. And he also ran a travel agent, which eventually paid to relocate the Great Cockcrow Railway here. So I'm going to go and buy my ticket, and let's go for a train ride. I just bought my ticket. Well, I bought two actually, because we're having two rides. So we go out here. There's a little garden railway down there, which is quite a nice addition. Oh, you put 50p in the slot. There's one. Yeah. So put 50p in. Maybe I'll do that later, and then get the train go round. So what we're going to do, we're going to go around here. Now, there's, as I said, there's two routes. If you have a look, there's two queues. There's a green arrow, not as in the steam loco, and a red arrow. I'm going to go for a ride on the red route, so each ticket you buy, which I've just dropped, each ticket you buy is valid for one of the rides. So I'm going to go and do the red route, and let's go and ride the Great Cockcrow Railway. I've just boarded the train. My locomotive's ahead of us, so we're going to go for a ride on the red route. So I'm very excited about this. It's been more than 10 years since I was last here. It's a very nice busy station. There's locos coming in and out. There's another train there, but it hasn't got a loco yet, and there's some that have just come in, so it's really quite exciting. It has the atmosphere of a really busy railway station. It looks like it's time for us to go now. have arrived at Cockcrow Hill. This is the terminus, the turntable's just up there. The Millennium Line runs right around there and the passes. The hill just over there, that is Cockcrow Hill itself. Now we can't see it because of the trees and bushes, but you might be able to hear it. The M25 is just behind there. So it's been on the M25 where I had spotted this hill and always wondered what it was. You can just see our loco just going off to turn on the turntable up there. So the loco will turn and then come past us. The train in the other platform, that was the one, the loco we passed Wensleydale as we came in. So they've got their loco so they can depart for the journey back to Harkwick Central. So there, there's a little signal box, and that signal box has a lever frame from the Waterloo and City line. I'll talk about the other signal boxes because there's one at Everglade Junction and there's one at Harkwick Central. I'll point them out when we get back there. I can just see our loco has turned around now on the turntable. What I'm going to do, I'm going to watch our loco go past, and it'll be time for us to ride back around the system, see a bit more of the track we haven't yet seen, to Harkwick Central. Thank you.
As long as he knows where the brake is, that's all I get.
I've had a great afternoon here at the Great Cockcrow Railway. There's still one or two locos out, but most of them have gone back into the shed and most of the visitors have gone home. It's been very enjoyable though to visit. It's very interesting. It's all fully signalled. I mentioned earlier about the signal box down at Cockcrow Hill. Over there, that's the Harkwick Central signal box, which has a lever frame from Crewe South, I believe. And over there at Everglades Junction, which we passed through, they have a lever frame, fully working Westinghouse frame from Croydon, South Croydon, I think. What we're going to do now, though, we're going to go and just walk back out the front of the station. So there's the shed. You can see a Black 5 there. There's another Northeastern steam loco there. There's no one waiting in the queue. When I came on earlier, it was quite busy. One thing they do is they do a loyalty card, which is quite good. So what you do, you get stamps on each ride. So I've had two rides today, so you can come and have a free ride. So it's worth coming here quite a few times and having quite a few rides, especially if you want to clear your winning locos. So what I'm going to do now, I had a cup of tea earlier, so I'll just show you, and cakes, I'll show you the tea room, because that's quite nice. We're going to walk along here and we'll go and see what's going on down this end. There's not a lot more because I've pretty much, everyone's gone home. Look, the car park's empty. My Lada's one of the only cars left in the car park. It's very much worth coming to visit, this railway. It's a very interesting railway, lots of locos running. It's fully interesting from the signalling point of view as well, not just from the railway point of view. Let's see what's going on around here. Over there, there's a Q-class locomotive. Now the real Q-class, there's only one Q-class locomotive preserved, and it's at the Bluebell Railway, and it actually is that one, 30541. If you want to see a video of that, have a look at the link on screen now. You can see that was earlier this year. So yeah, there's not a lot going on now because it's the end of the day. I can hear a train coming though. Let's just watch this train go past. They make quite a gradient coming up, quite a gradient into Harkwick Central. That little tank engine is called Wensleydale. Interesting, because there is the Wensleydale Railway up in Yorkshire, which I've not been on yet. That's the loco I travelled behind when I did the green route, so that's a separate video. If you want to see the green route, which I don't talk in, just enjoy 20-minute steam-hauled ride through the countryside. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. Do come and visit them yourself. It's a little bit of a walk from Chertsey Station, but it's not impossible if you wanted to walk here. So, from the Great Cockcrow Railway... Oh, there's a carriage being gravity-shunted. From the Great Cockcrow Railway, thank you very much for watching. Please do feel free to like, subscribe and comment. Goodbye.